According to the Gospel, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshipped him, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated and present to the Holy.
Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We may baptize the most of us, and we may children, our parents, bring us to the church. Today, also one child was baptized after the 9 o'clock Mass. We baptize in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You know, the name of baptism, is the Greek word, means entering. Baptize is enter in the community, in the life of God, who is Father, who is Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity, one God, in three persons. In the Old Testament, we listen today, the first reading, God, yes, Moses said to the people, there is only one God, no more. Yes, one God in three persons, one divinity. The Jews, the Muslims, until now, they don't accept three persons, only one. So they don't accept Jesus is the Son of God. They don't accept the Holy Spirit. But we receive the revelation in Jesus came to reveal us and sent God as the Father, and I am sending you another, the Paraclete. He will help you to understand everything that I have to teach you. The Holy Spirit will teach you and sanctify you and help you and to carry on the mission. The mystery of the Holy Trinity is not to be studied. Before, I remember we went to the seminary, we struggled to explain this mystery to ourselves and to the people. Not mystery to study, it's to live in, it's to pray, to worship, to visit God's family. And already, the first page of the Bible, the first chapter, Genesis 1, God said, "Let us create human beings in our image and likeness." He said, "Let us." God said, "Let me." Already is the inside means the community of three persons. And God is love. God is love and said, "God, let us create human beings in our image and likeness. Let us create them in love and for love." And when you are married, woman and men said, "You both, there is no longer two, but one." When you are married, you always, when people get married, I say, why you are married? Why you are married him? Why you are married her? Always said, because love, because I love him, because I love him. Love, let us become one, is the mystery. God is love. If only the love makes us one. Three persons, God is relational love, the three persons. And the Father loves us, loves Jesus, and because loves us also, sent Jesus first, become human being to be with us. Then Jesus, the Amphoper, then ascend to heaven, and the Father.
Father, with Jesus together,
send the Holy Spirit to be with us and invite us to join in His life, to live in Him, to live in the Holy Trinity. Is our vocation, is God's plan. We to be the God in His plan is integrate the human beings to live in Him, to become one in Him, to live in love with Him. Jesus said, you love one another as I love you. And then you will realize the other people, the non-believers, they will love God, the disciples, if you love one another. To be united in love. If we live in love, we love it only, we accept one another. We love only respect one another. But if we live in love, we will sacrifice for others. The people really love is giving the life to others. In the family, the mother, the father, sacrifice for the children. Because they love them, they give them, they do everything for them. They suffer for them. And we learn this. The highest lesson of the Holy Trinity is to accept another. We are so different. Everybody is different. In the family, all the members are different. But one family, and we must be in the bucket of life. The Holy Trinity is the nation of life. Then we Christians are invited to accept this mystery, to receive the communication of God, receive His love. And Jesus is sending us to proclaim this good news to others, invite others to accept the divine love. And this task is not easy because we have enemy to oppose the plan of God to be united, to be one family. We have enemy who divide us, who separate us, who make quarrels, who misunderstand to one another, and to avoid proclaiming the name of God in the society. We must make intention, really to make big effort. Why else I am telling you in emphasizing this to make big effort? Only last night, the Caritas, supposed is a Catholic institution, but they have a dinner for fundraising, big dinner, so many people come. But in the schedule, the time, the schedule was no blessing, no blessing, no plan. And then to try, I was there, and to make the moment for blessing, it was not easy to go in, to put in the schedule, because they had timetables, and so many father to have a timetable, and it's the government to control the time. They were really absent and worried how to make a small prayer there. So, we must insist, we have to give up. It's interesting, because we are thinking, the world is sinking, we are living at the sea, we don't want to put God in the center. Jesus said, I am with you always, I can be with you, but we don't want God to be with us. We try to split God from our society, from our families, from our hearts. So the people are experiencing, we experience that, the desperation, suffering. So, Jesus insists, I am with you always, go, and make disciples of me. And really, we must decide, we must try to put Jesus there in the center, and we need to serve him. Jesus to redeem us, this is the result of Jesus. To be the cross. To serve him, because love. If we really love the person, instead of the person lost, we will serve him for them. We never give up. So, my brothers and sisters, this is what we celebrate, the mystery of the Holy Trinity, to live with Him, the family of God. And this is our destiny, to live with Him forever. Jesus came to live this time with us, to live on earth, to provide something with us, so that we can live with Him in heaven forever, for eternity. Let us assume our mission and treasure that Jesus is telling us, all advice, everyone in the name of the Father, Now so many Catholic families, Catholic parents, they don't baptize the children, they decided when they grow up, they decided to be baptized or not. So they don't teach them to give the values of the gospel. But it's really, really painful. For this we must feel pain, suffering, because of this the commitment with the Lord more and more. We can pray that the Lord will help us, that the Holy Spirit to enlighten us, to strengthen us, to be courageous, don't be afraid of anything, to really make other effort to put Jesus in the center first of our own life, of our own heart. Then put Jesus in the center of our family. Then with our family, put Jesus in the society with our friends. Don't be afraid if you go for supper, for lunch, to eat with others. Pray the food. The other people ask you to love them, to love them. But we must believe, we know only the Lord is the recipient. You know, we are lost. But Jesus is here with you. You know the champ is with Jesus. The champ is with God. And God is glorified when we give Jesus. When human gates are open and receive the redemption, accept the Lord, then accept the Lord is the only way of happiness. The people have peace, have happiness, have at the same time patience, you know, suffering, but at the end you triumph over the demon, you have a triumph over the dead, and then the God is glorified. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Listen.